Hey, what's up? My name is Nick Wichman, and today I wanted to talk about one of my favorite B-roll tools called lens whacking. Let's get into it. So lens whacking is a term that's used when you have your camera and you've got your lens and you're in an environment or a shoot and you want to do something dreamy that feels less controlled and more abstract for your footage. Essentially, all it is you take the body of your camera, you take your lens, instead of putting it all the way in, you actually pop it off, create a little bit of gap, and then you let the light leak in straight onto your sensor and shoot like that. It takes a lot of practice to get the perfect shots, but with the right settings, I think that I can help you get a lot more really dope shots that you will be able to use for B-roll everywhere. First, I would like to quickly talk about B-roll though. B-roll, what is B-roll? B-roll is the part of the footage that you're capturing that is adjacent to the rest of the story. If you're shooting a travel video to wherever the hell, the Maldives, the travel video to the Maldives with the destination and whatever you do, that's the main footage. The B-roll is all those little moments that tell the deeper part of the story with emotion, with feeling and tactile nature, with sounds, with whatever, setting the scene. Generally speaking, when you're shooting, it should be about 10 times the B-roll to the normal story footage. So 10 times the amount, because a lot of that footage isn't gonna get used, but you need it, so there's tons of great environmental setup for you to leverage in the film. Lens whacking is a type of B-roll that is disconnected from normal tactile environmental shots. It's more emotional and abstract, and that's okay. So you need to kind of understand the type of film you're putting together, but it's really fun to shoot, and it can get some really cool results. When you're shooting with your lens, I like to start with a lighter lens. Here's my 55 1.8 or a 35 2.8 lens. Little ones. These are tiny little dudes. Look at those. They're just cute as a button. You're gonna have to hold and balance your lens in one hand and your camera in the other. So you can kind of prop them together and stabilize them, but the bigger the lens, the harder it is to kind of just hold it all still and keep the shot going. I love using these types of shots at shows, at DJ events, bands playing, shows, whatever, performing. If you haven't seen, check out my video right there about shooting for live events. I talked briefly about lens whacking, but for settings, I would usually start at shooting 60 frames per second, which means you're gonna need your shutter speed at 1/120th. You can slow it down just a little bit, down to 24, so that's 40% speed, and then adjust your exposure and your aperture to match that, whatever you want for the scene. I'd usually have the aperture super low, the exposure, don't overexpose, because when you're gonna be pulling the lens off the camera, it's gonna let quite a bit of light in, even at dark concerts. So you kind of want to balance on the fly. So either 60 frames a second, or I would even consider going to 120 frames a second and be able to slow that footage down to 20% at 24 frames a second. So at 120p, 120 frames a second, you want your shutter speed to be 1/240th. Adjust the exposure and the aperture for your liking. Pop it off, and then you're able to shoot, and the amount of frames that you'll have to work with will be really flexible, and you can slow the footage down a ton to get really moody shots. The biggest challenge with lens whacking is stability. You can't use a gimbal, you can't use a glide cam, it's handheld, so you've really gotta try to find the perfect spacing between your lens and the camera. Keep it right there, and just gently make little adjustments to kind of let more light in, let less light in, adjust so there's different light sources coming towards you and you're focused on different focal points, and just make little adjustments. And I would just try it, just try this. You just put the lens on your camera, get it in video mode, pop the lens off, barely pull it out. A couple warnings that I should give you, because shit can get crazy real quick. Number one, hold on to your lens like it is your firstborn child, because if you drop this especially in a bar, the chances of something going terribly awry are high. And with the back of this open, it could really mess up the lens, break the lens, or get a ton of junk in there. A second warning is that if you're in the rain, be very careful lens whacking, because there's water everywhere and your sensor is open to the world, even if just a little bit. It's not super safe. So you're taking a little bit of risk. And in bars and venues, be really careful that there's not that drunk person running around with their drink sloshing all over, because if a drink gets spilled on your camera and it slips right between your lens whacking lens and your body of your camera, you might have a freaking vodka soda all over your sensor. Not great. But that's really it. Try it at home, do it, turn on some lights. The way I prefer for lens whacking is to find some cool, colorful lights, some neon lights or something, and you just pop it off and test it. Give it a test drive. Let me know how it goes. It's really simple. Be careful, be mindful, and make something cool. And that's it. If you like this, why don't you hit the like button, leave me a comment. I'd love to hear how you use lens whacking in normal footage. The value in it for B-roll for me is very high. So I do it pretty often. It's really moody. If you can get it stable, it feels really cool cut in between different types of environmental shots and personal shots. If you're shooting on a subject who you're getting, it's kind of a close-up shot, and you're kind of getting to see their emotions, especially at an event, they're dancing, whatever, and then you cut to lens whacking between whoever's on stage, which is under stage lighting, and then the people on the floor, which are dancing and having this emotional movement to them. There's something really magical being put together there with that visual. If you can shoot it at 120 frames a second, you slow that down to 20%, whew, whew, it's good. And it just bridges the gaps between your normal content really well. That's it, lens whacking. Give it a try, tell me how it goes, and we'll chat later, I guess. Send me your stuff you're working on, I'd love to see it. Good luck.